You may not notice anything different about this DOT worker.
Gonna go down there?
But 4 years ago, Chris Howe made headlines driving a truck.
Howe and his passenger drove over an anti-tank mine.
The Newport native survived an IED explosion while towing wrecks for the Army in Baghdad.
Anything that most of the stuff got blown up, I'd have to go get it.
In November 2006, Howe unknowingly drove over two anti-tank mines.
So when I went to pull back over, it went off underneath the front axle.
In the blast, Chris suffered severe head injuries. His arm was so badly hurt, doctors almost amputated it. To recover, he went through dozens of surgeries.
Yeah, the total on my arm was 37, and then I had, six on my eye.
Chris is now on medical retirement from the military for injuries that continue to haunt him. He takes daily pain medication. There is no feeling in part of his left arm, and his right eye never recovered.
I'm blind in my right eye. I got some scars left on my face. I took care of a lot of them. My arm is metal from the whole elbow piece is all metal.
Since returning, Chris was married and divorced and has a 2-year-old daughter. The only obvious tie to his war days is the tattoo that reads Enduring Freedom.
Come on, Zay.
We caught up with 21-year-old Matthew Katka at the Dublin Christian Academy alumni game.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. Just, couldn't be better. I'm still alive, so.
The Army specialist was serving in Afghanistan in July 2009 when a bullet hit just beneath his helmet during a firefight.
Hit the skull and just pretty much kind of shattered it a little bit.
Matt spent 7 days in a medical coma.
And for me, it was just like, I saw this it was like being in a white room for a while. And it was I'm not dead and I'm not alive. I was like, where am I?
The young soldier suffered a brain injury and had a titanium plate put in his skull. At first, he had trouble speaking and moving, forgetting even how to say the word 10 when asked how bad his pain was.
No, I'm not. I'm sitting there crying because it's it was a 10. But I could only say one because that's the only thing I remember.
Today, his speech is almost fully recovered. And while he can show off his soccer skills, Matt still has vision issues and needs therapy to correct his balance. He is now awaiting medical retirement from the military and taking classes for a college education.
Gent was shot in the back and in the foot.
Rochester National Guardsman Richard Gent was also injured in a firefight, this time in Iraq.
Yeah, this is my unit crest, 3197th.
This is Specialist Gent 4 years later, still bearing the scars of an explosion that nearly ripped into his spine.
They were actually really surprised that it was that close to it and I was able to walk away from it.
In 2006, the then 20-year-old was serving alongside Sugar Hill soldier Jose Pequeño when the team witnessed a car bombing.
So as we were calling it in, we had three insurgents come up on the backside of the bridge on us.
A hand grenade was thrown into their Humvee. The explosion killed the driver and severely injured Pequeño. But Gent managed to get to his feet.
I regained my composure, saw that they were still on the bridge, and then I charged after him with my 9mm.
Gent survived the firefight despite being shot in the back. He was later awarded the Silver Star. When he returned to civilian life, Richard worked as a corrections officer at Stratford County Jail, rubbing elbows with the likes of Sheila LaBarre, Gary Dodds. He and his wife had two kids. And despite the fact he still has ringing in his ears and fragments in his back, Gent got his wish and shipped out to Kuwait with this guard group in September.
I obviously signed up for a reason when I first enlisted when I was 17. And, that reason still is with me.
Now, I wanted to point out one other detail of Richard's story. He showed us the boots he had on that day, and notice the numbers on the sole right there. He says many soldiers put the last four of their social security in case they needed to be identified after an explosion. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.